It all started in 1905. Adam J. Casper wanted a church near his home. He was tired of having to hitch up his carriage to drive all the way to St. Alphonsus, a bit more than a mile away. He wanted a German church with a school that was close enough to walk to. So he began talking with his neighbors who lived near the intersection of Orchard Street and Deming Place. As luck would have it, James E. Quigley was the Archbishop of Chicago at that time. And one of his main concerns was founding new parishes in neighborhoods where the nearest church was too far away. So, in early 1905, when Casper and his Catholic neighbors wrote to Archbishop Quigley asking for a parish, he quickly agreed. The school broke ground first, and the church followed in 1918. It was built as a miniature version of St. Louis Cathedral, with a Byzantine dome inspired by Istanbul's Hagia Sophia.
In the early years, St. Clement grew and thrived. But eventually, we hit our first rough patch.
You're on the phone with your girlfriend. She's upset. She's going off about
something. It was 1929, and the stock market had crashed. Chicago, a great manufacturing city, was hit especially hard. Local unemployment rose to 42% by 1932. The neighborhood around St. Clement was working class, and many of the old mansions on Deming Place were converted into rooming houses. But no matter how bad things got, enrollment at St. Clement School did not decline. By offering tuition of $1 per student, providing free tuition for the younger children of large families, and soliciting generous donations from those who could afford it, St. Clement survived the Great Depression.
St. Clement's fifth decade ushered in a lot of change.
I am not the kind of girl who should be rudely barging in on a white veil occasion, but you.
St. Clement's founding pastor, Monsignor Rempe, passed away in 1946. His funeral was held at the church he had founded, built, and nurtured into a thriving parish. For the first time ever, St. Clement welcomed a new pastor, Reverend Edward O. Leister, from suburban Naperville. Reverend Leister's time at the parish coincided with a period of great change, including the Second Vatican Council, the Civil Rights Movement, and the Vietnam War. During this time, Reverend Leister launched the inaugural issue of the St. Clement Anchor. The Anchor was a weekly bulletin covering topics as wide-ranging as marital advice, the dangers of over-imbibing at the office Christmas party, and thoughts on achieving peace with Russians, the Arab-Israeli conflict, and tolerance between Catholics and non-Catholics. During this period, participation in social and service activities at St. Clement grew.
By the 1970s, St. Clement Church found itself in disrepair. It was time for some improvements. Father John Fahey became St. Clement's pastor in 1975. At that time, the buildings were gloomy, and the neighborhood was not safe after dark. Our school was at risk of closing. But Father Fahey led us through a major transformation in just a few short years. He started with a commitment to quality education. He didn't want to be a cheaper alternative to other private schools. Instead, he wanted to provide the highest quality education with a strong Catholic identity. He had to sell one of our buildings in order to afford the maintenance needed to make the school bright and safe to do the work to attract educators. He also led the first major capital campaign. By the time Fahey retired in 1989, St. Clement was once again a vibrant community of faith with a beautifully renovated church and a strong lay leadership.
We were flying, but we never get far. And that brings us to modern times.
Introducing St. Clement's latest era.
Today, St. Clement enjoys the largest young adult community in this archdiocese. We support spiritual growth of individuals and families, and we keep our parishioners engaged and supported. And so this year, Paddle Raise will go towards supporting three important groups of people. First, we will designate a portion of those funds to go to those in need. Secondly, as we'll keep supporting your formation of your children and adults here in the parish. And third, we'll support our young adult community and our outreach to the next generation of Christians.
With the largest enrollment in school history, the money raised tonight will also continue the work that Father Fahey started nearly 50 years ago. It will go towards continuing the tradition of academic excellence while also supporting our students' emotional needs. As we did 2 years ago, half of the funds raised during the paddle raise will continue to fund two positions for two additional years, social work and an additional child first teacher. These positions support our students and staff in ensuring student needs are met.
Thank to you, our last anchor bowl was our most successful paddle raise ever.
I think that's because our parish is just a tiny bit competitive.
I know I am.
Oh, I am as well. And last anchor ball, I think Team Peter raised a little bit more money than Team
Yes, Finn. We did. Yes, we did, everybody.
Uh-huh. So I think we should try to do this again.
We will do it again. And Team Peter will win again.
Oh, you think so, huh?
I am absolutely sure of that.
We'll see about that. Do you want to make a wager on it?
Let's do it.
Okay, fine. You're on. So let's see. Anybody who's sitting on this side of the ballroom is gonna be on the winning team, Team Taylor.
And everybody who's on this side of the room, including those two tables, you guys are on Team Peter, Team Travis.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sure. So whichever side raises the most money in tonight's paddle raise wins.
Mm-hmm.
So make sure you guys raise your paddles high and let's make this the best era yet.
We cannot wait.
You know that if this doesn't work out and we don't get enough paddles raised, we are never getting back together.
Like ever?
Ever.
That is so gross.
I feel like it's 1989.
Mm-hmm.
It's me. I'm the problem. It's me. If we don't get the money, I quit.
I am never, ever watching this video.
I'm not going to quit. I'm just going to be upset.
Okay. That's fine. Fine.